So I'm really excited about being a mom, but I'm not really sure if I should breastfeed or bottle feed. I'm not really sure what the big deal is. I know lots of babies that were formula fed and they seem just fine.
I want to be clear that both human milk and infant formulas are considered acceptable sources of nutrition for infants in that first year of life by the medical community. Infant formulas have been around for over 100 years, and a lot of research has gone in to make sure that they meet the nutritional needs of infants. Still, it's not possible for formula companies to reproduce human milk. So let's compare human milk and baby formulas on some key nutrients. And I'm going to place a check mark by one side or the other if there's an advantage. So let's start with energy content. For this variable, I'm actually going to start off by giving check marks for both of them, because the energy concentration is really equivalent between human milk and baby formula. And as long as the mother's consuming at least 1,500 calories, she's going to be able to produce sufficient amounts of milk. However, I'm going to give an extra check mark over here for the human milk. Assessing energy is more than just how much energy is in the product to begin with. Healthy breastfed infants tend to consume less milk than infants on baby formula. It seems that those breastfed infants are satisfied with fewer calories and have an overall slower growth rate. Now that's considered a positive because higher growth rates are associated with increased obesity later in life. In addition, there seems to be less gastroesophageal reflex, which just means throwing up, in those breastfed infants, and this is most likely due to a more rapid gastric emptying, so leaving the stomach more quickly, and leads to a less overall loss of intake. For protein, the check mark is clearly going to go with the human milk side. Baby formulas are adjusted so they have the same amount of milk as protein as human milk, but it's the type of protein that cannot be duplicated. Human milk has protein that is more easily digested, and it seems to reduce overall GI tract disturbances in those infants. Now, fat's an important one, and because fat is considered the most important composition of breast milk because it supplies energy and helps to develop the central nervous system. And we're going to see a pattern here. We're going to give a check mark to the human milk. Human milk has more unsaturated fats, and especially ones called DHA, that's needed for the regulation of growth, vision, and cognitive and motor development. These differences between human milk and baby formula are especially important for premature infants because mothers normally transfer a lot of these types of fats in the last couple months of pregnancy. So that is going to be important for those premature babies. Another factor here is immune factors. An infant's immune system is immature. It's not fully developed when they're at birth, and therefore they're not as able to prevent some diseases. Human milk contains many different types of bioactive compounds that can help protect against infections. It gets the check mark on the human milk side. When it comes to vitamins and minerals, we're going to put check marks on both sides again. Baby formulas are very similar to human milk. They've been developed that way, so there aren't a lot of differences. But for some minerals, such as iron, it's much better absorbed from human milk. But human milk is low in some nutrients, for example, vitamin D, and baby formulas are fortified with that, so it will meet the infant's need. If an infant is exclusively breastfed, he or she will need to take a supplement of vitamin D. When you consider all of these variables, we need to conclude that human milk is better.
Okay, so I'm convinced that human milk is better nutritionally for babies than formula, but I do have to go back to work. Can I still go back to work and nurse?
What happens during breastfeeding is as the baby suckles, it sends a signal to the brain, to the hypothalamus, which is connected to the pituitary gland. The pituitary gland, in turn, sends hormones back to the breast. So these hormones are oxytocin, and prolactin. Prolactin causes milk production. So that one's easy to remember because lact is the root form for milk and pro is for it. So milk production. While oxytocin causes the breast to squirt milk for the baby. The presence of oxytocin and prolactin are vital to continued milk production. If you continue to breast pump while you're at work, these hormones will still be produced, and you should have a consistent milk supply. Your baby can then drink the milk that you pump the next day while you are at work. By law, employers are required to give you the time and space to pump.
You showed me the nutritional differences between the human milk and the baby formula, but are there any health benefits?
Breastfeeding offers a variety of benefits for both the mother and the infant. Let's go through a few of these. The mothers who choose to breastfeed delay menstruation, which can conserve iron, delay ovulation, and can more rapidly contract the uterus back to the pre-pregnancy size. Additionally, breastfeeding can offer protection against breast and ovarian cancer and provide a cheaper option than buying formula. For infants, the composition of breast milk provides optimal nutrition for an infant. It is a softer curd, which is easier on the infant's GI tract for digestion. Within the first few days post-delivery, colostrum is produced, which is a watery, milky substance rich in antibodies and white blood cells. Mature breast milk is a sterile source of milk that also contains immune factors, protecting the newborn from disease. Allergen risk and chronic disease risk are also reduced. Overall, both the mother and the infant benefit greatly from breastfeeding. The mother and infant develop a deeper bond through skin-to-skin contact, which in turn increases maternal behavior and sensitivity towards the child. In summary, breastfeeding can benefit both the mother and the child. For the mother, it'll delay ovulation, spacing out children, and can be more economical. For the child, it offers optimal nutrition content as well as immune factors. Together, both the mother and the infant can develop a deep bond.
That was really helpful. I've been debating this for a while, so I think that at my next doctor's appointment, I'll ask them a little bit more about it.